In a strange way, he feels at ease. He is armed with his own words, and when the time comes, they will be enough or they will not. For now, he's content to let the currents take him toward the final confrontation. Once more, we return to the drive-in. If he's aware of the absurdity of arming oneself with a few sentences and standing against a power that can pierce time itself, he doesn't show it. The man has his share of weaknesses, perhaps more, but cowardice is not among them.
Oh, you got yourself a little plan, do you?
Thank you.
never getting out of this wake. Never! Don't worry. I'll take care of your wife and your life. Think you're doing, but I'll send you right back to the beginning.
When the dark man's eyes suddenly locked into Serena's, she flushed hot. They ignited a black fire in her. He was talking. He wanted the power turned off. He said something about the projector booth. She hooked a finger under his belt buckle. He grabbed a hold of her throat and twisted until it hurt. Somewhere deep inside, a part of her screamed in paralyzed horror. But the moan that escaped from her throat had no panic in it. "Pay attention," he said. "Business first." His eyes glittered shamelessly. Hers did too.
What? You think whatever it is you're gonna do is gonna make a difference? This'll end up just like before!
I've been around for a while now, you know? Well, you've been...
There's more to fighting the Taken than just burning away the darkness that protects them. When I'm fighting for my life, I find myself slipping into a state of intense concentration that makes the beam of my flashlight seem more powerful and focused. I used to think it was just my imagination, something brought on by the adrenaline and fear of death. But now I'm not so sure. I've been touched by powers that I can't begin to truly comprehend. And they've left a mark. I'm starting to think this might be a part of it.
And indisposed, stuck in the darkness. I've been busy. I operate in the shadows, not always literally, you understand. I'm a little more resilient than those I've taken, but I do my best work in the dark. And there's so much darkness out there. It goes deep. And the things that live in it are vast, big bastards. They don't mind getting a little bit of elbow room. All that chaos and madness, it doesn't really do that much down there. It's like pouring a glass of water into the ocean, right? But up here, yeah, you can really make an impact. All they need is someone to bring them all the way through. But first, I had to take care of you, you party pooper. You're stuck in an eternal cycle now. The sun's never coming up for you. Everything else? Do my thing. Getting a bit of quality time with Alice? That's a little something for me. And I deserve it.
Again, the Champion of Light enters the final trap. The new reality is almost here. All he needs to do is change the details of the scene, push it past the breaking point, and the rest will snap into place.
Oh, come on, buddy. Why don't you... What? What is this?
No!
No!
You can't do this! All I did was take the things you always wanted and never had the balls to go for! It's my turn now! It's my life! It's my...
too long, enveloped in the light of a glorious dawn. They both feel it. He's home at last. Are these actual events, or merely a dream, a memory, or a glimpse of what is to come? One thing is certain. This scene takes place in another time. And another place, far, far away from Night Springs.
A picture. No. Al?